Anyway, this guy, the vets weren't helping him. So he went day and night and took some courses in animal husbandry and nutrition, tested his soil, balanced his soil, proper minerals, and he put it in his feed. And pretty soon his dairy was operating in black while he was making money. So the neighboring ranchers and dairy women, instead of calling the vet, they were going to him for advice. And he said, this all got to do with nutrition. It all got to come from the soil. It's got to be in the soil and we're not connected. So he was asked then to teach a continuing education course on that down at A&I. And 18 students are going to sign up for their class. And the first day of class, he told the students that half of the food on the grocery shelf wasn't fit to eat. They challenged him. They said the FDA wouldn't allow it wasn't fit to eat. So he said, tell you what, let's just prove it to ourselves. He said, the college got that big group of pigeons. They're fixing us to do away with it. They'll let us have them for tests. He said, we're going to go to buy that big pennant, equal age and sex and both sides. One group, we're going to feed them brown rice, unpolished rice. You really can't tell much difference with that. And the other side, we're going to feed them white rice, polished rice. And he predicted those on brown rice were going to get calcium crowd, and those on white rice were going to get degenerative diseases and stop reproducing. So they did the test. Guess what were the first symptoms of malnutrition? The pigeons on the white rice got airborne, discontented, started fighting off the cell, had low wage and ADD. Those on the brown rice, they produced normal, they were contented, they were never fighting, and they were perfect. Well, at that time already, my wife and I was only eating whole wheat, you know, brown rice, living natural foods, nothing processed. My folks would come out and say, hey, ain't you got some yeast bread? Who can eat you some brown bread? So I decided, you know what, I'm going to do that test, except I'm going to eat whole wheat bread and white bread. They all bought those baby chicks, and I swiped six of them from them. And this guy, with that picture test, he gave me a cook. So I put three baby chicks on one side, he put six other chicks, and three baby chicks on the other side. One side got white bread only, the other side got whole wheat bread only. The first one was white bread. I think it was a 12 or 13 day. The last one, by the 18th day, the white bread was dead. And instead of growing normal, they got real blubbery fat, and their little legs spread far apart, and they started sitting around chirping. They were kind of fighting. They were discontented. And the first one died, and I cut it open, it was white jello-like, clear jello from the skin of them. Awful. He dropped into a green instead of the normal white brown like it should be. Those on the brown bread, I kept them. Those on the 18th day, all three of them white bread were dead. Those on the whole wheat, I kept them until they were full grown. I don't remember exactly how many days they were. Two of them hens, one of the very little deer's roosters, turned the hens loose to the lamb flock and put the roosters in Thanksgiving. So we don't need no more white bread. Don't eat no white rice. Eat brown rice. There's two things that change the world. The whole world changes. Outlaw refined rice. The 100% whole grain rice, because that's a big state around the world. And the other thing is, stop doing white flour. Use 100% brown flour, or the whole grain ground up. But they take the brand off of it, mix that coffee, that's where all the minerals are. Take the germ out of it, that's where all the vitamins are. They need carbohydrates, you're supposed to get all that stuff. needs to say, we don't need no white ribbon. We'll never have white sugar in the house. Honey, brown sugar, whole wheat bread, wine concentrate. There's all kinds of good breads now. You get the HEB, the Central Market. I mean, they got some good breads on the market. Delicious stuff, whole grain, 7 grain bread, anything else. Just raisins in and you can live off of it. But the good food is available. I've been giving those away out there. That book, written by Dr. Barbara Steph, she was a probation officer. And she'd get these guys out of probation and then right back in. Get them out of probation and then right back in. Meanwhile, she was living on donuts and coffee. And pretty soon, her peers were telling her, Barbara, you're part of your homeless. You're snappy, you're never happy. And this one lady said, I believe it's your life. Every time she went studying, and she asked Barbara what she would do. And she said, hey, get off of donuts and coffee only, and start eating whole grain syrup and stuff like that. And it changed her whole attitude. And then she got to thinking, these guys that she's getting out on probation all the time, they always got right back in there. So some of the guys, they were willing to listen to her. She told them, look, why are you eating? Well, they're all the junk food. Home junk food. And she said, do you want to come back in here? They said, no, it's always in back, in that back in here. She said, well, let's go on this kind of a diet. Those that went on a basic diet don't get back. Good behavior. And you get a lot of studies on that. And she published that book. And I've been buying those books for years now, getting them to every mother and every school teacher came into place. And I got a book, so I thought about Father Step. And she said, well, her husband and her will retire. All she got is 4 boxes of Book Step. I said, I want them all. Here's my credit card number. I'm going to do a credit card number and check. So I bought all 4 boxes. It's important. So simple. We can shut the jails down. Clean out the hospitals. This is the only reason why. Just change the rice and the wheat berry. Eat the whole thing. Stop not drinking too many Cokes. One good for you once in a while. Cokes are the better one out there. Don't give off the soda water for tea. Make your own tea. My wife likes to make tea and we put all kinds of stuff in. I make tea out of palm leaves and drink it. I make tea out of mint.
Would you go over number 5?
Number 5, do nothing to harm the beneficial life. That means don't go out there with a poison dust or spray. If you got troublesome insects on your plants, that means they're stressed. If you really get to study nature, you begin to see there's a master designer. And everything on earth was designed to be of service and aid to us. Study from that approach, all of a sudden you get smart. Instead of just figuring out how to kill everything. But these people that say, oh, you accidentally happened. I wasn't an accident. Maybe you were.
Not me.
No, there's a higher power. And he put us here for a reason. And everything out there is to be of service and aid to us. I don't care what it is, but you've got to study and approach it from that point of view. Do nothing harm the beneficial insects. Consider troublesome insects and diseases as symptoms of one of the above five rules being violated. Pretty simple. We don't need to go to college to figure that out. I never went to college. I finished high school, but I took 4 main subjects, reading, writing, and then getting a girl. That's all you need. Unless you're a boy. I mean, a girl, then you get a boy. I read my book. I love to read. All self-taught. And I like to attend other people's conferences and classes and stuff, but everybody knows something you don't know. And I try to put it in some books. I got a bunch of books. Now, I've got a lot of steps with her. The last time I talked to her, she had 4 cases left, and I got all 4 of them. So So San Antonio gave West with her last full box of votes. And I can fully give her that, I'll be excited. But I have mothers to have, as they are school teachers. So the kid can jump out of school. It's going to change the world with her philosophy. Do you say that? Can't people admire it?